In this video, we will discuss how to calculate crystallite size from XRD data using Origin. From the XRD graph, we will calculate the full width at half maximum, and then we will utilize this value to calculate the crystallite size. We will use the Scherer equation, and the Scherer equation is that crystallite size is equal to K lambda by beta cos theta. This equation is valid for crystallite size up to 200 nanometer. In the Scherer equation, D is the crystallite size, which is usually calculated from the most intense peak in the XRD pattern. However, calculation of the crystallite size from one peak is not suitable. We will have to calculate the average crystallite size, which is calculation of the crystallite sizes from all peaks, and then we will have to average those crystallite sizes. K is the Scherer constant, whose value ranges from 0.68 to 2.08, while for spherical crystallites with cubic symmetry, this value is approximately 0.94. The value of Scherer constant is very important because here we can observe that D is directly proportional to the Scherer constant. So the value of Scherer constant changes the crystallite size from approximately 70% to 200%. The value of the Scherer constant is supposed to be exactly known, otherwise the crystallite size will not be authentic. To see that what value we should utilize for the Scherer constant, one may consult this article in which the different shapes and symmetries have been discussed and Scherer constant has been calculated there. Here lambda is the X-ray wavelength, which is for the copper. K alpha is 1.5406 angstrom, and this we know experimentally. Beta is the line broadening at FWHM, and we will have to use this value in radians. Origin will give this value in degrees, and we will have to convert this into radians. And finally, theta is the Bragg's angle in degrees, and in XRD we do plot two theta values, so we will have to take half of that value. From our XRD plot, we will have to calculate beta and theta, and then we will put in this equation and we will calculate the crystallite size. But before going through those calculations, let me first discuss what is a crystallite. We know that in an atom, a positive core, which we call nucleus, is at the center, and the electrons are orbiting around like a cloud. When these atoms are placed at specific distances, we call the lattice constant. It forms a unit cell. Different representations are here, so an atom is shared with its neighbors, and depending on the structure, the number of atoms in a unit cell can be determined. For simple cubic, body-centered cubic, and face-centered cubic. When these unit cells are arranged in a specific manner, we call it a crystallite. Sometimes these crystallites are in a single pattern and we call it a monocrystalline, and in some situations they are in different patterns and we call it polycrystalline, and in some cases we don't have a long range order and it is then termed as an amorphous. When these crystallites combine in different orientations, we call it a grain. And the boundaries of these crystallites are called the grain boundaries. And when we combine grains with each other, it forms a particle. And inside a particle, there may be one or more than one grains. So we can simply say that a particle will always be greater than a grain, and grain is always greater than a crystallite, and then it is greater than a unit cell, and unit cell is greater than a molecule or an atom. Now, in order to find out the value of full width at half maximum and the location of 2 theta, we are having this as the XRD data. Let me plot this data. Now as I look to the data, then we are having two intense peaks, one medium peak and two small peaks. Usually, from the very intense peak, we calculate the crystallite size, but it is much better to calculate the crystallite size from all individual peaks and then take the average of those sizes, which we call the average crystallite size. So I will calculate for the most intense peak and we can do for the rest of them to find the average crystallite size. So let me explain how to find out the full width at half maximum. Now select this peak, go to analysis, then fitting, and go to nonlinear fit and open the dialog. So we are having the origin basic functions and go to the Gaussian function. And here it will show us some preview, so I can go on by fitting it. And I will click the fit until converge. And here is the fit, so I will click OK. And here are the values. So our values are, our XC value, the location of our peak is 44.95887, and of the full width at half maximum is 0.23779. So we will need this value and this value for our calculations. So let's go to our calculations, and here is our Scherer equation. The value of beta is 0.23779. And the 2 theta value is this one. So let's put this in the equation. D is, this is the value of K, which I'm assuming the spherical cubic crystallites. And this is 0.94. This is the experimental value of the X-ray wavelength. And now I will have to take the radian of this value and then cos. And here is theta is there. So I will have to divide this 2 theta by 2. And as I do calculate, these are the values, the multiplication of this, and then the radian of this is equal to this, and cos of this is equal to this. And we will calculate this one in degrees, not in radians. And this gives us the crystallite size is equal to 37.76 nanometer. This I calculated for one peak. Similarly, we can calculate for all other peaks and then we will take the average. In order to calculate the average, I will share with you this Excel file. And here we are having the parameters is the Scherer constant and then the X-ray value, which, and here is our value of the 2 theta. And this is the full width at half maximum and the calculation is here, which is done as I did in the previous slide. Crystallite size comes out to be 37.76. Similarly, we will do calculate for rest of the peaks. We will find the FWHM value for those peaks. This will come out to be the average value of all these. So this way, the crystallite size, the average crystallite size is more authentic to report and publish. Thank you for watching the video.